Left Behind, The Kids' Number 2 Audio Theater Edition is based on the books Left Behind, The Kids by Tim LaHaye and Jerry Jenkins.
Oh, what is that smell? Jeannie! Nice going. Who did this? That ought to do it for this pot. Who's the idiot who left it on the stove? Shut up! Dad! Mom! What is going on here? Mom would never leave all this stuff out. Hey, Shelly! She looks wasted. Shelly, what's the matter? Can't you hear me?
Huh?
You all right, Shell?
People are missing, Vicki. All over the world, people disappeared. Right out of their clothes.
What are you on, Shell? Shelly, what are those fire trucks doing here?
Two trailers burned down last night.
Who?
Maxwell's. And those guys on the other side of the office. Grant, I think. What?
Maxwell's and the Grants were good friends of my parents. They all went to the same church.
Isn't somebody gonna get that? No, really, it's okay. I'll get it. Dad's truck is still here. Why isn't he getting it? Washington's.
Hi, Lionel, right?
Yeah, who's this?
This is Verna at her office. Is your mom there?
She's not up yet. You want me to wake her up?
No, on a big news day like this, though, I figured she'd want to be in the office.
Yeah, I'll let her know you called.
Please.
Where is everyone? Mom, your office called. Mom? Dad? Mom, you in here? Oh, Mom, where are you at? Reese, are you in here? Lucy, Ronnie? Oh, man, don't even tell me.
I couldn't figure out what she was making such a big deal for. Nothing was wrong with the plane that I could tell. Except for her, everything was quiet. Everyone was sleeping.
People are gone. Sir, my husband seems to be... I found
what is she doing with his clothes?
We'll be back.
What is going on here?
You want me to turn on the cabin lights? Excuse me.
Trouble, ma'am?
It's my husband. He's gone.
I'm sorry?
He's disappeared.
What is going on here?
He probably slipped off
people
to the washroom.
Just don't
while
disappear on an airplane.
Would you mind checking? And take this blanket. I'm afraid he's gone off naked. He's a religious person, and I know he'd be terribly embarrassed.
What?
He's gone.
Oh, no. No! This can't be happening!
It's just a siren. It's not even close to here. Man, why are you so jumpy? Everything's just fine. Everything's just fine.
For Global Network News, this is Monty Harrison. The disappearances have taken their toll on the nation's highways. Individual states are finally beginning to dig their way out of the 16,000 related accidents. They hope to have the mess cleaned up by the time schools reopen in 10 days.
Aw, man, they're gonna make us go back to school.
What'd you expect, permanent vacation?
I was hoping.
Besides, Ryan, we gotta be the ones telling everybody about what really happened.
You mean why everybody disappeared?
Well, yeah, except everyone didn't disappear. Did they?
Nope. No, I guess they didn't.
The Kids Left Behind. Episode 13, 1,000 Points of Light.
So when I finally made it home from the airport, everyone was gone. My mom, my dad, even my brother and sister.
Wow, man. You must have flipped.
Gotta tell you, Rickman, I was sort of expecting it. As soon as someone on the plane said something about her religious husband disappearing, I knew my family was gone.
Well, it's a tough break. I mean, it's kind of weird, because a month ago I was looking to pound on you.
Yeah, I remember.
You're not still planning on pounding on him, are you?
No. Whatever ticked me off before, it don't mean nothing now.
I hear that.
Yeah, me too. The only thing that's important to me now is to tell as many people as I can about what Jesus is all about and what he did for me.
You say that like everything that's happened is a good thing.
No, what Judd's saying...
Dude! This is a mess! And not just here in Chicagoland. This whole world is one big soup sandwich.
Soup sandwich?
Yeah, that's a new one on me, too.
There ain't nothing you can tell me that'll make me see good in all this.
You sure about that?
Man, don't even.
Listen, I'm gonna go grab another cup of coffee. Why don't you let Judd here tell you what he believes, and you can decide for yourself.
And what if I decide that I want to pound on him again?
Well, then that's your decision.
Oh, thanks, Bruce. Appreciate the support.
Yeah.
Cool. Ryan, come here. Look at this.
What's up? You find some more computer games?
No, look at this.
What is that? Looks like the Elephant Man.
That's me.
It is not.
Yes, it is. I used the scanner over here to scan my face into the computer.
You look like you were kissing the glass.
Yeah, well, you gotta get your face real close.
Hey, can you scan pictures and stuff and then change them around?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how to do it, but I know you can.
That's pretty cool.
Judd said his dad used to make the company newsletter for his work. I'll bet he did it on this computer.
Cool. Hey, let's see what else this thing can do.
Come on, Bob, you gotta be there.
Hey, Vicki, check this out.
I'm on the phone. Hang on a sec. Oh, for crying out loud, I know he wasn't taken in the rapture. Talked to him since then. Either you know when Judd's coming back.
Didn't say. He just said that he and Bruce were going to Lissell's to talk to some kids.
Lissell's? Oh, Lissell's. That's new coffee shop.
Yeah, Lissell's Viennese Cafe. Sounds like the place to be.
Either way, lots of kids have been hanging out there.
I think Bruce is becoming a caffeine junkie.
I think he needs it, Ryan. He doesn't sleep much anymore. He's always studying.
Hey, Vicki, check this out. What does this look like to you?
Looks like Lionel did a nosedive into the scanner.
Is that like a computer crash?
Yeah, Ryan, that's just what it's like.
And in Romans, it says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Oh, well, so the Bible really has a lot to say, huh?
You said yourself, man, the world is messed up. Who knows what might happen to you tonight?
Yeah, I guess.
Hey, let me ask you something.
What?
After everything you've seen on the news, everything you know, and everything you've heard tonight from Judd, can you think of any reasons why you shouldn't accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
No.
Well, let me give you some.
What?
Huh?
You know, lots of people tell you that if you accept Christ, then your life is going to get better. Everything is finally going to be all right. Unfortunately, that's just not the way it is.
Bruce?
Jesus said that if you follow him, you must take up your cross daily. Now just like the Roman cross was heavy, well, the stuff you're going to have to deal with will be heavy, too.
What do you mean?
Well, the next several years are going to get tougher and tougher for Christians. The Bible promises persecution, not a tiptoe through the tulips.
Then what's the point?
Don't get me wrong. The payoff is going to be awesome and eternal. Like forever. But until that time, well, you're going to get slammed, humiliated, made fun of, and abused. That's the price of following Christ. And let's face it, we don't need any more phony Christians. There were enough of those.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.